Alright, so we're heading into map number 2 between Miu and Zeus, the German human leading 1-0 against the Croatian Night Elf player. It is Secret Valley and it is a mover first by Zeus, so I expect we're not gonna see a Warden here and not a Demon Hunter either, but a Tavern Hero. And I think we've seen several Night Elf players go for the Dark Ranger first on Secret Valley against Human previously, for Beastmaster first against Undead previously. I'm not so sure if we've seen a Beastmaster first on Secret Valley against Human thus far. I don't think so. So the Dark Ranger should be the most likely choice. Miu, on the other hand, starting with the Altar first and the Barracks and the Farm. So he's gonna go for an AM, pretty sure. Don't think Miu ever played anything else but the AM first. And Zeus, yeah, is gonna add the second Moonwell soon, is gonna add the Altar soon, is gonna start producing the first Archer here soon as well. And there's the AM on the side of the German. So second farm is coming as well. And yeah, I'm curious to see what the strategies are going to end up being here on Secret Valley. I'm expecting Zeus to go for a more solid and, you know, just not as cheesy all-in-ish gameplay compared to Tarina Stand. Especially with the Dark Ranger, usually you wouldn't expect to see a crazy tier 1 all in. Miu, on the other hand, is most likely to once again go for his fast expansion and just end up working from there. First footman is being sent out here, Scout Wisp is being seen. The Scout Wisp is not going to find anything particularly surprising. Next Wisp is arriving here. AM is out, he's not going for the Gnolls at first. Heading out towards the green camp here without Militia as far as I can tell. The Altar is about to finish here, so we're gonna see Tavern Yuri here in the middle just in a second. Footman continues chasing one of the Wisps. And yeah, Miu with some very, very slow creeping here early on. He, is he not going for a fast expansion? Now he's putting the Militia. He stopped producing peasants, so this is a little bit strange, and he doesn't add the next farm as well. Okay, now he's producing another peasant. Some weird macro here by Miu, and the Dark Ranger is about to just arrive to finish the first Gnoll Overseer with a Dark Arrow. Oh, but he finished one of the Gnoll Assassins with the Ancient of War here, so a little bit sloppy by Zeus. Really shouldn't happen, and Miu is not going for the expansion here just yet. He is just creeping his Gnoll Camp now. So a little bit of a strange creep route here by Miu, who's adding a scout farm here just to make sure not to miss an expansion. But actually the expansion is coming here. So yeah, Zeus going for a quick expansion here together with that Dark Ranger, which should be able to back that up early on pretty nicely thanks to the large number of skeletons she's gonna have available to help her defend here. Miu in the meantime slowly continues with a tech here. Okay, so very, very uncommon for Miu, who's always been known for going for fast expansions, and in this case decides not to do so. So what can we expect here? He's adding a lumber mill already. Yeah, usually when you'd see the tech, the first strategy that comes to mind is the blacksmith eventually and the rifleman caster play. So we'll see if Miu is going to decide to go for that, and if so, how well he's going to fare with that. In the meantime, the Dark Ranger is already closing in, slowly closing in on level 3. She's found the talisman of evasion here, claws of attack plus 6 previously down here. Has not started his tech yet, so okay, now he started his tech. So he's going to be on tier 2 a lot later. Then again, he's getting his expansion into play, and if he does so successfully, that's going to end up, you know, putting quite a bit of pressure onto his opponent. The AM is running away. Did he not? Wow, did he just miss that? Perhaps. Or he saw it, and he decides to nevertheless go ahead and apply some pressure, perhaps cancel the Hunter's Hall, which is not yet coming. He actually did not see the expansion here. Very, very crucial. If he just came in here and, he'd probably been able to cancel it with a perfect timing that could have backfired horribly onto Zeus, but the way it went, it didn't. Zeus has not lost a wisp thus far. The Dark Ranger TP is in a pretty awkward position though. Mio is blocking her away. Dark Ranger needs to move towards the bottom. The first of the footmen can not prevent the Dark Ranger from eventually moving, reaching the moonwell, as Zeus was able to move one of the archers out of the way here. Next archer is healing and stays alive behind the tree of eternity, tree of ages here for the time being. AM has to move away, and Mio has lost two footmen here already while not dealing any real damage in return. The first archer is now falling here to the AM. Still a favorable trade for Zeus, especially given that his expansion is going to be following afterwards. I think the deny was too late. I do believe the Dark Ranger did get the XP. So yeah, Mio was able to force a TP here, but well, was that worth it? Not so sure. I mean, the Dark Ranger did end up getting the majority of this creep camp in return, and therefore gets a huge XP advantage here early on, level 3.5 already against his AM, who's only level 2.5. Naga second picked up for Mio, who has reached tier 2 in the meantime. He's getting a defense upgrade, and he has not added a blacksmith, so we're not gonna see the expected blacksmith and rifleman strategy here by a one base human against Night Elf. So what is the plan here for Mio? Still go for an expansion just on tier 2? I mean, he's gonna creep it right now. He's gonna have defense finished eventually. He's got 5 footmen to his disposal, which, you know, without defense against 6, 7 archers and the Dark Ranger are pretty easy targets. With the defense, we'll see how well he's gonna be able to work with those. And yes, Mio does pull the militia, so it looks like he's gonna wanna go ahead and go for a tier 2 expansion here against Zeus's Dark Ranger and large number of archers. We'll see if he's going to able to still manage to get a decent advantage with that. But then again, keep in mind, Mio has not at all scouted this expansion yet. I mean, he may have gotten a clue when he pushed here and realized how late the tech of his opponent was, but I wouldn't be so sure that Mio knows exactly what's happening here. 3 ivory towers have been placed here, and Zeus immediately scouts what's happening, and he starts applying the pressure here. So there is defense available for the human, but that's not gonna help all too much against the skeleton's damage output, as well as the breath of fire by this panda, who, excuse me, has picked up a staff, a heal scroll, and an invoke potion, so he can even afford to get surrounded here. Dark Ranger has reached level 4 in the meantime as well. I'm not so sure how much of a difference level 2 silence is gonna make here. But yeah, the footmen and the peasants all by themselves are gonna have to try and defend here against the skeletons, which are going to even be rising in numbers here as far as I can tell. The 3 towers have finished though in the meantime, but both of the players are losing a lot of their units. It looks like Mio doesn't really have all too much of a meat shield left standing, but he's going for the town hall. Nevertheless, another archer is falling. The next breath of fire is coming in. Only 2 footmen left standing here. At the same time, only 3 archers left standing as well. Dark Ranger is using her wand of mana stealing against the AM just to be able to fire off these dark arrows for a little bit longer. And yeah, Mio really has nothing left, but neither does Zeus. And it looks like he's gonna get the town hall cancelled, but is he gonna be able to work against these 3 towers? I'm not so sure about that. Yeah, especially with the Naga, which makes microing away stuff extremely difficult. Both of the Night Elf heroes are in some trouble. The Dark Ranger does have nothing, actually. He's passing the Invo Potion and is getting away for the moment. But keep in mind that Zeus doesn't have a TP here, so this Dark Ranger is going to end up getting in trouble here. The boots have been passed onto the Naga, but she doesn't get a cold arrow off onto this Dark Ranger. And therefore, the Dark Ranger might be surviving. Both of the players losing so many units here. Mio down to 24 supply. Zeus still at 35. I imagine he started producing right now in his Ancient of Lore. Yes, he did. And the advantage for the Night Elf right now is that he already has the expansion to back him up to create a huge army again. Immediately, Dark Ranger has used the Staff of Teleportation to get back into safety, healing up immediately. Does he have a shop already? Yes, he does have the shop here. Could buy a staff if he wanted to. Doesn't do so just yet, and now Mio, as the Pierce, is definitely going to confirm that there is an expansion already for his opponent. Does he click here and see that this one's been running for a little bit already? It looks like he does not. Ah, now he just clicked it. And now he knows Yeah, this expansion has been up for a little bit. At least this is going to win some time for Miu to get his own expansion into play. The Dryads are coming in right now. He should be able to micro this one out very easily, as they are extremely fast and yeah, extremely difficult to chase down. The AM is probably even going to be forced to town portal here. The Naga should definitely make sure to get in TP range or just run away, which seems to be a just fine choice as well. So Miu is getting up his expansion. He's going for tier 3 as well, so it looks like he's already given up on the notion of going for a timing push here against such a quick expansion by his opponent. Usually the human wants to get the expansion more quickly and gather up some resources and go for a nice like 70 supply push against the Night Elf, who's at like 60, but in return has you know, an advantage in terms of hero levels and in terms of tech as well, as it's going to be tier 3 and have bears. But speaking of that, Zeus is not going for tier 3 here. He's just massing Dryads. He really, really wants to be aggressive right now and trade extremely favorably, which should be very easy for him if Miu decides to give him any trades. At the same time, is he going to be able to really break into the space with the Dryads? He's killing one of the farms here. He's going to be able to kill a second farm eventually. He could just poke forward very quickly with his Dryads and make sure to not get let that tower get up. The Naga of Miu casting a Fork Lightning here, not doing all too much. This pressure is really going to be important for the outcome of the match, let's put it like that. If Miu is going to be able to hold this very easily and not take all too much damage and go for tier 3 and get like Mortar teams with Fragmentation Shards and Knights, then things are going to be difficult for Zeus in the long run. However, if Zeus is going to be able to deal a lot of damage here, maybe break in, kill peasants, then Miu is going to have a very hard time establishing a tier 3 army. On top of things, yes, we're going to have to keep an eye on the main base of the Night Elf, who's going for tier 3 afterwards, so he's not all-inning or anything like that. Just delaying his tier 3 tech here for the chance to apply a lot of pressure. He's gonna have to go for this tower here eventually, and if he decides to do so right now, I think yeah, this could still be very painful for Miu. Zeus decides to go for the already standing tower in turn though, and he's got nothing on his panda. He needs to pass the staff onto the Dark Ranger to make sure to get that panda out alive. He's moving the Dryad away, but it looks like the panda is gonna fall nevertheless. Sloppy staff management by Zeus, going in very aggressively with his panda and not having the staff of preservation on his Dark Ranger, costing him the panda as well as two Dryads, as well as the hunt, but that didn't really matter to him anymore anyways. Which is going to take a lot of steam out of this push. Zeus still tries to keep the pressure up. This is by no means a decision of this game already. Keep in mind, Zeus still has the expansion running. He's still going for tier 3 as well. He still has a very strong Dark Ranger to work with here, which is already closing in on level 5. But he's given up a lot of momentum. I mean, keep in mind that Miu really had no units to defend against this. Only a few towers. His first Mortar team has spawned right now and his two heroes. So Zeus is going to have to go for a little bit more of passive play for the time being. Get his panda back, get his first bears out. He's got the Ancient Wind finished already, as previously mentioned, so he can add Fairy Dragons against potential casters. Yeah, he's got one already. Or even start Hippogriff production against, you know, potential Griffin Aviary units, but there are no Griffin Aviaries for Miu yet, who, as I said, he has taken a lot of damage here. He has been, he hasn't been able to just smoothly transition into a big tier 3 army. He can produce Knights and Mortar teams though. And the Fairy Dragon, well, he's gonna be useful for some scouting, but with the unit composition Miu is currently striving for, he shouldn't really be adding all too much Dark Ranges. Just chilling at the fountain right now. Panda gets an orb, gets a mana potion. And the Dark Ranger is going to get level 5 in just a second. But is he going to wait for the panda with the rest of the creep camp? He should really not finish this red drake before the panda comes in. There's the panda. One of the creeps has been finished right now. He really, really should wait with this red drake. The panda is coming in right now though. Zeus is not pulling the Dark Ranger away for the... Yeah, now he does. Giving the panda the solo XP for the remaining creep camp. So yeah, Zeus still has a huge hero advantage. Zeus is at 64 supply already against 54, so despite losing his panda, he's still looking extremely strong here. Panda almost level 3, Dark Ranger level 5. These are Perfectly fine hero levels for him. He does have two staffs of preservation already, so this bear is not going to fall. He's going to be staffed in just a second. And this is a very awkward position for Mio, who I think is committing too quickly here against the Night Death army, which seems to be pretty much ready already for this fight. Should really morph the bears here, which he's doing right now. The Dark Ranger is in a little bit of... under a little bit of pressure. I'm not really sure which staff is on cooldown right now, so if it is the staff of the Panda, then this Dark Ranger is going to be in serious trouble, and the next Holy Light should be able to finish off this Dark Ranger. He doesn't even need it. The Dark Ranger, the Naga is doing the job with the Cold Arrow, and therefore it looks like he used the staff on the Panda previously instead of on the Dark Ranger, not realizing the potential focus fire of this human army against his first hero. And yeah, losing the first hero certainly doesn't help Zeus at all here, and the Panda is the next target, so Mio is really, really just relying on the hero focus, as he's not able to, or as he doesn't seem to be able to take on this army just straight away. But so far it's been working for him very nicely. The next bear is going to get taken down by the Naga. This bear is being staffed in the very last second by the Panda. Yeah, getting as much tanking done by him as he just can. And it looks like the staff by Mio on cooldown as well. Yeah, perhaps he staffed the Mortar team here just previously with the AM. And therefore one of the heroes of Mio is falling as well. And yes, despite killing the Dark Ranger, it doesn't look like Mio has the necessary army size to break Zeus here at the moment. There are still a couple of skeletons remaining. Dark Ranger has been rebought on the tavern by the looks of it. Did get a rejuvenation, is back to full HP immediately, which is something something Zeus can just easily afford thanks to his very, very early expansions, thanks to the very strong economic situation he's finding himself in. So he does have Dark Ranger level 5, Panda level 4, 78 supply against only 56 of Mio. Yeah, a bunch of Mortar teams, a bunch of knights for Mio, but the bears are doing so fine against these knights. He's got the way superior number in terms of those units. The the Drys, of course, need to be very careful against the Mortar teams, because if they're not, then they're just splattering in a second, which is exactly what's happening. But it looks like on the front, Mio just doesn't have the numbers to deal with all of those bears of his opponent. The next knight is going to be taken down, and yeah, what is Mio really supposed to do? Perhaps a Griffin Aviary would have been a smarter choice, and waiting longer until, you know, committing for a fight here. But as it looks like now, he's just getting totally ripped apart by these bears, who are getting into a very good position against the Mortar teams right now, killing 2 out of 3. The third one is extremely low on HP. The 3 bears in the base can wreck the entire economy, as only 1 Arcane Tower is left standing here. He did get rid of the rest. Yeah, AM needs to be careful. The Panda doesn't have anything, but the Dark Ranger with the Dark Arrow, level 3 Dark Arrow, is able to seal the deal here and finish off the AM. Zeus, I think, got very, very lucky here early on. Or, well, Mio just didn't scout sufficiently, which was fortunate for Zeus, who did get his expansion through without any trouble. Mio did go for a decently timed aggression, but inside the main base, he just didn't get anything done. Whereas outside, had he been able to cancel the Tree of Life, I think things would have looked a lot differently. Mio ended up trying to go for the tier 2 expansion, which can often run into this exact problem, which is that the Night Elf is very easily gonna get up to bears and it's gonna get a strong army, and the human often ends up not having the time to benefit from his expansion long enough to go for a big timing push, which then again Mio didn't really decide to do. He went for tier 3 and then just try to go for Knights Mortar teams, which didn't end up, you know, with him having the army size necessary to deal with Zeus's army, who just had an advantage of like 10 supply already, plus strong heroes, despite losing the Panda unnecessarily into in Mio's main base. And yeah, then with you know, decent heroes, bigger army, well-teched army, expansion to back him up, he was just able to deflect Mio's push and go for a counter push with, like, I don't know, 8 bears against like 5 knights or so, which was just too much to handle for the human player. So we are tied currently. It is 1-1. We're gonna have one last map on this playday number 4, and that is going to be Turtle Rock.